Welcome to V8 Nation, talking all things motorsport with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to V8 Nation. If you'd like to get involved with the boys, Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell, very, very easy to do. All you need to do is hit them up on an email, v8nation@crocmedia.com, or you can tweet them at V8 Nation. Make sure you're following all the latest news and podcasts and everything that goes on in the show on that very site. And so welcome the boys, Rick and PD. How you doing?
Very well. How are you?
Yeah, doing really well. Looking forward to Winton. It's on next weekend, and I'm sure you two boys are pretty pumped up about it.
It is. It's always good to go to the local race where you test at. And it's quite funny. You look over the history of the V8 supercars, all the Melbourne teams, you have to test at one track, and the designated track in Melbourne is Winton. And in the Queensland teams, it's Queensland Raceway. And it's quite funny. The Queensland teams come down. We do 4 or 6 test days at Winton, and we know it back to front. We know how to set the car up. And the Queensland teams come down, and they win. And then we go up to Queensland Raceway, and generally a Melbourne-based team wins. It's incredible, isn't it?
It is. Exactly what you pointed out was on the top of my mind at the test day earlier in the week. You tend to go there, and you talk yourself into being quite confident, and you run a good set of tyres right at the end of the day, and you put in a good lap time, and you leave there thinking that you're going to come back in a week or so's time and do an exceptional job. And I think that you can view a lot of teams confuse themselves as to whether they're going to be fast or slow at that particular round, because always qualifying in the race is during the middle part of the day when it's hottest. And when you're testing, the track goes away at that time, so you really don't bother doing much. You just wait. You do a good time in the start of the day and at the end of the day. So it's interesting. I think there's a lot of people that think that they're probably in the ballpark, and us included, probably yourselves as well. And hopefully leading into next weekend, we prove that we are in the ballpark and we don't get smashed by the Queensland teams again.
It's going to be like that, and it was quite interesting. I had a bit of an incident late in the day, Rico. It's quite funny. We're speaking about it pre-show. At the end of the day, as Rico touched about, everyone puts on really good tyres, goes out, and obviously, you know, tries to put a good lap together, and obviously you walk away beating your chest, thinking you're going to go win the next race. And we were no different. We were about to do that, and all the three FPR cars were out there at the end of the day doing about 5 minutes to 5 just before the track closed. And one of the other teams out there got on the radio to their drivers, because our team at a race meeting and also at a test day, they actually scan the other team's radios to sort of hear what they're saying about their car, what times they're doing or whatnot. And the other team came onto their radio to their drivers saying, hey, the FPR drivers, Frosty, Will Davis and myself, are out there. They just put on green tyres. Do whatever you can to sort of get in their way out there. So it's a big no-no at a race meeting. We actually had Shane Van Gisbergen, I think, actually penalised at Perth at the last race, doing that, blocking someone in qualifying. So it was so unsportsmanship to hear that actually go on. Anyway, luckily or whatnot, I think, you know, I guess cooler heads prevailed and they didn't actually get in our way. But it was interesting to actually see that, you know, a team would actually even be bothered in actually playing those games. But I guess, you know, you never underestimate what some people are actually capable of, Rico.
Yeah, certainly surprised me that someone would get in their way. I mean, I saw you guys out at that time trying to get a good lap in, and, you know, come across Will Davison a couple of times and ensured I got out of his way. But Peter, you're being very political there. Are you not going to sort of give us a heads up on who that
mate, it was absolutely GRM.
Oh no.
It was actually quite funny. I actually drove home with Will Davison in the car and we're talking about it, and I actually my engineer came on the radio and said, hey, watch out for the GRM cars, they might be playing some funny buggers. And I didn't think much of it until Will told me more of the story when we got in the car. So, you know, being a big Twitter advocate and loving, you know, putting some stuff on Twitter, I might have or might not have told Will it was a great idea to launch it on Twitter, but I saw, you know, he didn't actually mention the team. So I think we're probably breaking the news of what team it was. So, hey, you know, I'm probably going to get paid back the next round, but I just thought everyone out there should actually know what went on.
Just a little bit surprised.
And actually, Rico, you told me a story. I text you on the way home. We were talking about how quick we were going and, you know, just telling each other a few fibs.
Yes.
And Rico actually texted me and said, you won't believe what happened. They drove out of the track right behind you, and you're in your strict limo that you were cruising around in. And what happened?
Yeah, well, look, we were driving out of the track, and it was a van tailgating it, so we didn't know who it was. I had a front headlight out, and we're like, oh, this is sketchy. And then they pulled past us on the freeway and raced past us, and soon looked to our right and realised that it's a GRM boys, and they're hoiking everything they could find out the window at us, which, not ideal. I mean, that's my car. I don't want pies and bottles of water.
Was it the limo?
It was the limo. It was the limo. So we had important passengers in the back in Murph and Todd. We're trying to take care of. And there's, but look, I don't know. Interesting day. I mean, generally that team does a great job. They're quite a modest team. The two drivers I've generally found to be quite good. There's probably just a couple of monkeys in that team causing a bit of trouble on that particular day. It was a bit left field for those guys.
Right, I'm just going to jot down. Last week, Muppets was used a fair bit about some people. Now monkeys has been used. So. Jeez, I tell you what, you're really using this opportunity's forum of V8 Nation to just get some people rubbing them the wrong way.
Hey, we've got to tell them what everyone's really like out there. There's too much political correctness out there. You know, we're really here to tell everyone what we think.
You've been getting a little bit of grief because on this very program last week, firstly, we were disappointed that something broke in the media that Rick Kelly could have probably pointed us towards anyway.
Rico's engagement?
Yeah, well, that's a second thing.
Yeah, that's a second thing.
There's a few things that Rick just... And look, we understand he's a private person and we respect that sometimes. But when the mics are open, we like to know what's going on. And I've just got a bit of audio we're going to play. We're going to go back to 7 days ago when the Stig was brought up. This is what we got out of Rick Kelly last week.
I might be led to believe that the Stig, the ouster Stig, Ben Collins, might be driving with the Kelly Racing team. Now, Rico.
Look, we've had a great relationship with Ben Collins, who was the Stig for some time now.
No, that's all he gave us last week on this very program. And since then, I know you've been copying a lot of it. And I've been copying it off Twitter going, you don't let Rico off like that. Get stuck into him. So we thought we'd revisit it, Peter, and allow you to really get stuck into him.
I haven't been copying anything.
Yeah, I know you haven't.
No one's questioned me whatsoever. Well, so I thought it's died.
I put it to you, Rico, that you lied to us. You blatantly lied to us. You know exactly what's going on. Now, yeah, we're here, Camo here, we're here just, you know, putting us out to the people of V8 Nation.
You know, we're not getting around in limos, PD, it's fair to say, isn't it?
Times are tough.
I can guarantee that he is not, as it was in the papers, it said he was driving with Todd and myself, I can guarantee he is not driving for Todd and myself at the end
of the
round.
But you're answering half the question, though. Who is he driving with?
It's said in the paper. I can't tell you everything. I only know that he's not driving with myself or Todd. I don't know what's going on with the other two cars.
Who is he driving with?
I don't think he's been locked in.
Oh. Here comes another week, Peter. You're just copying it off Twitter and you can't even go down to your workplace or at Winton or testing because they're going to keep saying you're just going too easy on Rick. But, that's all he's going to give us. We can't spend all day on it. But I'm sure that sooner or later we're going to find out exactly what's going on with Ben Collins. And is he driving with you, PD? It's not going to be a reverse psychology type of thing, and he's going to get announced.
No, we're very happy with who we're about to sign, so we can't announce that yet.
Do you want to ask the question, Rick, or do you want me to ask?
Who's driving with you, PD?
I haven't signed with anyone yet.
Who are you looking at signing with?
Jacques Villeneuve.
Anyone else?
Absolutely. There's a few out there.
No.
I think to put this to rest, a little bit like the Vanilla Slice competition, we should get Ben on. We'll ask him himself.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Next week? Can we get Ben on next week?
Yeah. I'm not sure what time it would be in Europe, but we'll give it a good shot.
Yeah, that's fine. Hey,
we'll get him on next week.
We'll give it a go, yeah.
We'll give it a go. So no guarantees.
I know someone who knows him.
All right. Yeah, I bet you do. It's a day we've spoken a lot about when it comes to the V8 Nation, and it's probably the most important day on the calendar when it comes to V8 Nation. And PD over there is looking a little nervous. We talk a lot about it. I think it's what's the exact date of this big day?
The big day is Friday, September 2nd.
Friday, September 2nd. And a man named Mark Wilson, who is, he runs this big day, and we're hoping that possibly we'll be there. He's joining us on the phone to talk all about it. Mark, welcome to V8 Nation.
And g'day to you. Yep, thanks very much for having me along.
Now, just for Paul Dumbrell, who doesn't exactly know what's going on, and the listeners out there, you just want to explain exactly where you're from and what you do.
Well, we're in Oyen, which is in the northwest of Victoria. And you know what we have on Friday the 2nd, PD?
Vanilla Slice.
We have the Vanilla Slice, the Great Australian Vanilla Slice Triumph. It is a great day, and we're looking forward to something that you might not know about.
And I understand on the day you've got what we would call a celebrity judge. You might want to give our listeners a little bit of a heads up of who might be judging the amateur cooking competition on the day.
Well, we received an application in triplicate from one Paul Dumbrell.
Explain to us what that will entail. How many vanilla slices is PD going to have to try and eat on that day?
Hundreds.
We talk a lot about it in the ad breaks here at V8 Nation, how you want to get involved, a little bit jealous when Rick Kelly was asked to be involved, and now you are officially going to be a celebrity judge, and I assume this is a fairly big moment for you.
I've been working for my whole career for a V8 win, and what better way to top it up to, you know, go up the Oyen and judge with Rico? Because obviously, you know, we do it, we're a brother in arms, you know, we're V8 Nation. It's a V8 Nation supported event. So the three of us will be up here and we'll judge it all together.
This is V8 Nation with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell.